Now we're going to look at using electronic technology or our calculator to solve some of these compounding interest questions. So from the main menu in your calculator, you have to come down to the mode TVM, and we're going to be looking at compound interest. So along the bottom of the screen here, you can see that F2 represents compound interest. So I'll click F2 and it'll bring us to a screen that looks like this. Now, the different variables here are described on this PDF. So here it says capital N. On my calculator, it's a lowercase n. It just depends on the model of your calculator. So, but it regardless, it represents the number of compounding periods. So for example, if my investment is for 2 years and it compounds half yearly, each year it compounds twice. And the investment lasts over 2 years, therefore the number of compounding periods would be four. So two per year for 2 years would be four. In if that doesn't make 100% sense to you right now, in a second we'll go through an example and hopefully it'll become more clear. Now I represents the interest rate, so you have to enter that in as a percentage. So if the interest rate was 3.5%, you actually just enter it as 3.5. In contrast to how we've been doing questions in class, how we enter them as a decimal, where it would be 0.035. So that's very important to note. PV is our present value or our principal. Now, I won't talk about these two for the moment, but then P slash Y is the number of payments per year. So again, if it was compounding half yearly, the number of payments per year would be two. And CY is talking about the number of compounding periods per year. So again, it would be two. Now, just some important things to note. When we use the calculator, the initial investment is considered as outgoing, and therefore we enter it as a negative value. So again, in my example, you'll see what I mean by that. Capital T to be aware of. And then capital N represents the number of compounding periods, not the number of years. Again, on my calculator, it's lowercase n. So let's have a look at this example. So Sally invests $15,000 into an account that pays 4.25% per annum and it's compounded monthly. How much is her investment worth after 5 years? So n again is the number of compounding periods. So the investment is over 5 years and it's compounded monthly. So in 1 year, there is 12 compounding periods, but the investment goes over five. So if we want to know what the number of compounding periods is over the 5 years, it's going to be 12 times five, which gives me 60. Then our interest rate, again, we enter it as the value presented as a percentage, not as a decimal. So it's 4.25. Our present value of the investment. So again, this is where we enter it as a negative value. So it's going to be our, she invests $15,000, so it's negative 15,000. Now we can leave these as, well, we'll leave this one as zero. We're trying to determine what the future value is, so we're not sure at the moment, so I'll leave that one blank. Now the number of payments per year. Again, it's compounding monthly, so that means that it compounds 12 times per year. And finally, the number of compounds per year, again, 12. So I've entered all of my values. Now, along the bottom, you can see that we've got some options. Now, we're trying to work out what the future value will be. So therefore, if I click F5, which represents FV, you'll notice that it tells me that my compounding amount that it's equated to is 18,544.53. You'd have to round that up to a three. So you're now going to be working through some examples. By the way, if you want to get out of this screen, you just click exit and it'll bring you back to the initial screen where you can input each of those values. So the questions that you're going to be working through now are from chapter 3C4. Now, I have set quite a few of them, but they are really quick. When you're writing these into your book, can you please note for each question what the number of compounding periods is. So you can write N equals and you can write that down. Then can you please write what the interest rate is, etc., etc. Please do not just write an answer. I'd like to see the values that you're actually inputting into your calculator.